Okay, assalamualaikum and very good afternoon. Okay, so today we will be moving into a new chapter, okay, which is 5.0 enzyme. So in this chapter you will learn, okay, the most important thing that you need to know is the how does enzyme work. Okay, so there is one theory which we call lock and key hypothesis, but we are not going to discuss it today. We are going to going into the basic definition for enzyme. Okay, so first you need to know, okay, why do we need enzymes? Okay, so enzyme is a necessary for a process which we call as metabolism. Okay, so metabolism can be defined as any chemical process that occur inside our body. Okay, so you have learned many chemical process during your lower form, such as respiration, digestion, homeostasis. Okay, all of that it is a type of metabolism. Okay, however, there are two types of metabolism. Okay, the first one is catabolism. Okay, which is we want to break down a very large molecules, okay, such as carbohydrate, protein, fats into a small components. Okay, for example, carbohydrate, we want to break it into a very small component, which is glucose, that can be easily absorbed into our blood vessels. Okay, so we already heard about catabolism. Okay, majority that you learn before this, you learn about catabolism. Okay, however, we are going to focus as well on anabolism. Okay, so after we break down all those larger parts into a very small component, anabolism is how we want to assemble. Okay, we want to synthesize a bigger molecule from small components. Okay, for example, that you will learn in a nucleic acid, right? So you will learn that nucleic acid, okay, DNA is made up from nucleotides. Okay, so how do we want to make a very big DNA or chromosome from a single nucleotide? Okay, so basically all of these process require energy for catabolism, require energy to break down large to small part. Anabolism, catabolism will release energy, sorry. Okay, catabolism will generate ATP, while anabolism required energy. Okay, in order for you to make something bigger, so you require energy. Okay, you require ATP to assemble or to make, to synthesize something bigger. Okay, okay, catabolism, process of breaking down complex substances into simple substances. Okay, release energy or generating energy. For example, the breakdown of glucose during cellular respiration. Okay, okay, anabolism, okay, synthesizing complex molecule from simple molecules. Okay, for example, the formation of glucose during photosynthesis, and this reaction required energy. If there is no ATP, there is no energy, so anabolism will not take place. Okay, this is the picture, okay, overview. Okay, catabolism, breakdown of larger molecule, anabolism, synthesizing smaller molecule into larger molecule. Okay, this is the example. Okay. Okay, I think that's all for today. So you need to remember the definition for metabolism and two types of metabolism, catabolism and anabolism. Okay, thank you for listening.